Now there are 5 bumpers available for these trucks.
This week, Cam and I install a sexy and new to us grill while we tweak the Colonel's nose.
Be sure to like and subscribe for more great videos on classic car mods and restorations.
National Parts Depot offers quality restoration parts for Mustang, Cougar, Camaro, Firebird, Chevelle, GTO, Chevy and Ford trucks, Bronco and Thunderbird. For quality parts in stock and delivered fast from our 4 warehouses nationwide, nobody beats NPD's speed and service. For your free catalog, go online or call toll free. NPD, make your dream happen.
You found a cat!
Oh, she left. We scared the piss out of her. Well, that was our shop cat coming through the scene. Now your shirt looks like you need to...
We're going.
You gotta make a kitten now. It's not done by any stretch. But what I was doing is I was putting the front end, putting the grill on the front end so that we can, or I could look at it and see where we were at with the alignment. I just couldn't stand it. I had to do it. We're going to pull all that back off for everybody, take a look at what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. But the thing I really wanted to go over this week is that there are constants and then there are variables.
Yeah, the fenders are variables. You can move them.
And there's a lot of variables in there. Yeah. There's a lot of things you can do with those variables. I think if you really wanted to get sticky with your alignments on the front of these trucks, you could probably even go in and raise the radiator core support up a little bit if you needed to.
Then there's all the inner fender adjustments that affect fender fit.
Oh, man, yeah. And the inner fenders can be messed with because we're going to talk about that here in a second.
It also changes the depth of the hood because the bumper's on the hood.
At first blush, it looks like there isn't a whole lot of alignment ability on these trucks.
Yeah.
But when you really start boiling it down, there's quite a lot of alignment ability, and there's movements that you can do. One of the things that always has bugged me on these trucks is the gap on the hood to fender relationship.
Yeah.
And most of the guys will carry that from the front to the back.
Mm-hmm.
The bumpers have a set depth,
yeah,
which I don't like. I wish that there was a way to make those bumpers so that you could really hone that in, but you can't. Bumpers are what they are. But there's a lot more adjustment that you can do to these trucks than you might with first think. There's the, well, anyway, we're going to go into that in a minute. I'm going to go talk about the, new front bumper we have for the truck to go with the one that I bent on the back. Ran into a tree. Didn't see it.
It's like it just popped there. It hasn't been growing for years.
All right, so we're going to get started. I'm going to go talk about the new front bumper first. And then we're going to pull all this stuff off camera and then show you how to put it all back on. Because that's how we roll around here. Speaking of rolling, JK. All right, so the big thing for the week is our brand new front bumper from the guys at National Parts Depot. Now, there are 5 bumpers available for these trucks. This bumper was used all the way up from like 1966-ish to 1978. So it is pretty ubiquitous in the Ford line. And like I said, there are 5 of them. We have a painted version. We have an original bumper that is still available in limited quantities through National Parts Depot. We have 2 really good repros. This is one of the really good repros. They have this one, and then they also have one that does not have the tag holes in the front of the bumper. If you live in a state where you don't have to have a front tag, you might want to get that because it cleans up the front bumper pretty nicely. Getting rid of this in here. You still have the bumper bolts? What are you going to do? So, we won't be putting this on immediately because we still have to do some alignment stuff on the front end. That's what this week's episode is all about, as we said before. So I'm going to take this and just leave it lay right here, and we're going to get busy on making everything squished together in the middle.
Pull it to the middle.
Yeah, I'm going to pull it
all the way forward. And then go back with it.
Don't we go too loose?
I just let it sort of slide. Okay. Come all the way forward.
Yeah, I'm all the way forward on mine. Pull all this stuff out of here. Pocket all of it. Thank you.
That's a pretty cool look.
Cowl induction.
It's kind of like a ricer.
The thing that I'm worried about on these, on this truck, is I think the reason I pulled the bumpers out of the back.
Because it sits high.
Because it sits high on this side, but it's, let me see if I can get it to go back.
It's over to yours a little bit too. Oops. Oh wait, I snugged mine down.
Well, that's not going to do. So you can pull it up.
Yeah, it's a little bit.
Nope. Whoa. What's happening is that back edge is rocking.
Yeah.
So we're going to need to tighten the bolts down in the back. Watch that corner. I'm going to have to lift it from over there. Okay. Oh, bud, are you okay?
Yeah.
We're going to have to tighten that back one down. I'm trying to remember if it needs to go that way. Put some rear pressure on the hood.
What do you mean, like down?
Yeah, like pushing it this way. Yeah. Now, hours of fun can be consumed in doing this. Just this.
My hinge isn't tight, so.
Okay, go ahead and tighten everything down at the back. Get that back one tightened up and push up on the hood a little bit. It's hard to lock back all the way. Just slid back some on the hood. I want to get the hood hinges.
You want the front of the hinge up?
Yeah, up a little bit, like that.
Okay. Pull it forward.
Yeah, pull it forward some. There you go. Too far back on my side.
It's low on mine.
That's low, so we're gonna need to. Remember last time that one was a bear.
Yeah. I'm gonna do the smart thing this time.
Yeah, put that in there.
And use a tool.
You wanna get a trim tool?
Need something to keep it from rocking onto my fingertip. There we go.
Okay, so we need to bring yours.
Mine needs to come up.
Yep. Okay, now I'm going to be putting the cross piece in up here on the radiator core support, but what I want to go ahead and do, because we have the condenser for the Vintage Air AC system in here, and it has a mounting system that pulls it pretty close. I don't have the screw that came with it. I lost it. Stuff happens sometimes. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take three washers. That's usually about right for this. I'm going to take these three washers. I put them together using strip caulk between two of the three washers. I'm going to set this on the back side here to give me some spacing to get that to kick back a little bit. And I'm going to take my brace. The brace sits in here this way. In case you've got a truck that is completely disassembled. And I'm going to just loosely tighten this up because we got other things to put in here right now. Cross brace here, lay it in position real quickly. I'm just going to put this in right now. I'm not going to tighten it down or anything, but I'm going to set it, and then we'll come back and talk about it in just a second here. Put one bolt in. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and just put the two bolts in up here. And then what I'm gonna do is start talking about all of this.
Dirty.
All right, now what I'm gonna do is I've got this piece in, got the top cross brace in. Make sure when you do this that this piece sits outside of the this brace here. No other way for it to sit, but it could be inconvenient if this gets tightened up and you gotta undo it because this isn't in the right spot. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put the latch assembly on. I'm gonna take the latch off of the hood itself in order for us to do our adjustments, and then we'll final out our adjustments on that as well. I just want to go ahead and start getting all this stuff put together. And the cool thing is we've got a kit from the guys at AMK through National Parts Depot. This is a hood latch and catch kit. And you can probably at some point get a full body kit from the guys at National Parts Depot. I'm not sure it's available yet, but all the stuff pretty much on the front end of the F100 that we're working on here is National Parts Depot's AMK kits. All right, I'm gonna go and throw this down in the hole here. And just start these up. My new fasteners and clips. Nothing gets tightened up yet. We're just gonna lay this stuff in. There is a backward facing bolt here. I'm gonna tell you what, Ford did not want any of this stuff to go anywhere. All of this is just kind of crazy with how much stuff it's got in it. Now, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and get these other two bolts that go in here. But these bolts are actually for are part of a different kit, so I want to get those installed as well. And another, like I've said before, nothing gets tightened yet. Everything needs to stay loose. So for right now, I'm gonna grab those, get these two bolts installed in here. The bolts that are actually on the inside of the radiator core support are loose as well. This piece is loose. This is all loose, but everything is threaded up. Now I'm not gonna go in and install these two bolts right here yet, simply because it's not time for them. You don't really need those in order to align the front end. Those will go in when we get everything tightened up. Once everything's done, I'll go ahead and apply those two bolts to their positions. But for right now, the next thing I'm gonna wanna do is to put my recently repainted stone guard back in here and lay it into position so that we can kinda get that started lining up with the fenders. And then the grill goes in for a test fit to make sure everything's good. And then we'll finish up with the hood alignment, because at that point, we'll have the grill in here and we'll be able to know what else we need to do to make the hood sit where it's supposed to in relation to the fender end caps on the front. I think that's everything. Not sure. All right, got my stone guard, stone deflector. Just depends on who you talk to as to what it's called. And I'll set this in place pretty much right where it needs to go. Make sure that my wire that I have for my washer is not in the way. And I'm kind of hunting for holes here. You have these smaller screws, which I'm pretty sure go in the stone guard across the bottom here, and I'm going to install two of these right now just to get everything going, and then I'm going to start going in and moving around and doing the rest of the stuff. But I wanted to get the stone guard into position at the very least. And these are pretty shallow. They don't take a lot of getting in there, so to speak. And that's in. I don't want them really tight because I'm going to have to probably move this thing back and forth a little bit in order to get everything lined up. But there isn't a whole lot of wiggle room on your stone guard on these trucks. Really, I might would even put a longer bolt in here because of that. All right, so that's basically that in position. And now I'm going to get up here and I'm going to get the two ends bolts started through there, because they are through bolts that come out and they have nuts on the back side of them. This is where new fasteners are awesome. All right, get the fasteners, get going on that. All right, now I've got these fasteners here on the floor. I have a longer bolt that goes into a position I'll show you in just a second, and these two go into the stone guard and the fender. I'm going to put this one in first. It goes the long way. It actually runs in through the actual radiator core support, the fender, and the stone guard to tie all that together. And then I've got another bolt that goes in down here. I'm going to start this bottom one first. This stone deflector, stone guard, whatever you want to call it, has seen the wars. It's in pretty bad shape. So I'm going to try to get everything to muscle around a little bit. Get this in here and then pull that and put the nut on it. And I'm not going to, again, I'm not tightening anything up. I'm going to get it snugged up enough so that I can go and make changes on the outside over here if I need to. Not super tight, just kind of finger tight at this point. And we got one more that also does the same thing. It goes up here, and that's the one I'm most worried about, being able to get it to play nicely with others. All right, in the case of one of those things that you can do whenever you're doing this, when you're sandwiching three pieces of metal together, sometimes things don't work out like you want them to. What I had was the fender was actually outside of the sandwich between the stone deflector and the radiator core support. The fender should go between the radiator core support and the stone deflector, stone guard, whatever. And now when I put it the way it's supposed to be, everything lines up pretty good. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to finish this thing up by putting this, putting the bolts on, trying to get the bottom edge of this to line up nicely. The top edge is about as good as it's going to get since this thing has sustained some damage. And I'm going to get these started up, just put them on here for right now. And then I'll go through and do a tightening sequence on it. But it's much better than it was, which is saying something, because I was really worried before that I was going to have to do some serious mucking about. Now, I've lost my glasses, mostly because they fogged up and I couldn't see a dang thing, which that's why Cam and I sometimes, you'll see us using the squints. And I'm getting dirt in my eye, which makes me think I should have them on. But I don't. All right, now what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pull back here and kind of look at the front end to see where we're at. Oddly enough, as bad as I thought that stone guard is, and it is damaged and it's not in the greatest of shape, it's not as bad as it could be. It looks like everything's lining up pretty good. So when we go to put the bumper on the truck, we should be all right. But you always want to check stuff while you're moving through. One of the other things I'll say is when you're putting all this stuff back together, you want to make sure you get your marker lights plugged in before you put the grill in, because after you put the grill in, not as much fun to do. Well, I guess the only thing left to do is put the grill in. All right, now, whenever you're doing a grill setup like this, be sure you kind of understand how AMK sets up their bolt kits. There are things that Ford considered to be fender bolts, and there are things that Ford considered to be grill bolts. And the grill bolts are basically anything that attaches through the grill, except for the three vertical bolt holes on each side of the fender that bolt to the grill. So if the fender bolts to the grill and not the other way around, I don't really know how they do it. For some reason, those bolts aren't part of the grill setup, they're part of the fender. So you need to remember that when you're ordering the kit, because when you order it, there won't be enough bolts to do everything you need to on the grill if you don't order the fender bolt kit as well when you're doing this. So without further ado, I'm going to put the grill in. And what I want to do is I'm going to set this in as gingerly as I possibly can, because I've got paint here. And I'm going to see if I can put this up here, put a couple fasteners in, and snake the wiring in. As many fasteners as I drop, I always wonder if at the factory how many fasteners the guys on the line would drop. I know in my 72 Mach 1, I found enough interior trim screws to basically redo the entire car. Okay, let's see. Can I do this? Yes, I can. I made my leads pretty long on this on purpose, so it's easier to get the headlights pulled out. Without the inner grill sections in here, it's pretty nice. It's easier to get this stuff to line in install. Okay, now what I need to do is I've got everything kind of in position. I've got two bolts in here. I need to start looking at this thing and seeing where we're at as far as centering up on the two fenders and if the fenders are as wide as they need to be or as narrow as they need to be in order for this to work. To me, it looks like that inner guard piece here is probably a little bit over that way. It's not centered up on the two fenders, but that's kind of why I go ahead and put the grill in like I'm doing right now, because I want to see where this grill lies on the fenders. Right now, we're looking okay. I'm going to get these things in here and tighten it up a little bit and see if I need to move things around some. All right, I got the grill mounted in, and actually everything seems to be planing out and lining up pretty darn nice. We picked this grill up from a viewer a little while back when we put something out bemoaning the fact that we did not have a grill yet. And he had one available. We went and bought it up in North Carolina, and it's in a lot better shape than the one we have. Luckily, he was wanting to make his truck look like a 67 because he liked the one-piece grill a little bit better. We wanted to keep with our 72 grill. Bada bing, bada boom. Everybody walked away happy. What I'm doing right now is I'm starting to final tighten everything. I've got a basic lay that I like on this side. This section of my fender is out just a little bit, but I don't mind that so much because there is some damage on this side of the truck right in here. This is bowed just a little bit. Not going to be able to really fix that just simply because of the fact that it's already in paint, and until I go back in to repaint the truck and then probably also at that point replace the fenders, I'm not going to mess with this. So what I'm going to go ahead and do now, I'm going to show you that you have some motion here that you can make. Right now, my grill is a little proud. I'm going to pull the fender out a little bit, and it drops everything in a nice position. So now I'm going to go in, and I've got a screwdriver in here to pull the inner fender to the radiator core support. There's a big slot here, and I'm going to tighten up the inner fender now. Let it click in. And I'm also going to go in and final tighten this bolt here, because this is actually about where I need everything to be. And some of this adjustment can be made on the bottom part of the grill. Okay, that's tight. I'm going to get this one done too while I'm here. The other thing that's nice on these is you can actually tighten up this line and smooth this line out right here a little bit by going in and just starting in the center, get the center set, and then move from the center of the grill out to the outside edges, tightening up the bolts that are in here. There's a ton of fasteners on these Ford front ends. I don't know. Ford must have had a really good deal on bolts at some point, because holy wow, this thing is just full of fasteners. All right, well, I'm going to go in, and now I'll move to the other side of the truck where I've got a little bit more of a problem to deal with because it's not lining in like you'd want it to. All right, down at the other end, pulling this up and taking a look at it. It's flat and true, top and sides. A little funky right here on the corner, but I'm happy enough with it, so I'm going to tighten all this stuff up. It would help if I had the right end of the wrench. Position is good on the upper valance piece, whatever that's called, this piece here. Position's nice, so I'm going to tighten it down. Now this will all be final set by the bolts that are inside of the fender, and that'll be the next thing I do. Anyway, so that's the next step in our little thing here, and I'm not going to fully tighten this because I got a little bit of a surprise I want to talk about at the end of the video, something that I am planning on doing to this grill because it does need it. It's a little messed up. All right, let me get Cam in here, and we're going to put the motion lotion of this to show you how to get this to where it'll sit out really nice. Yep. All right, I've got Cam pushing on the inner part of this grill assembly at the back edge here to try to get our line a little bit better. And it's actually not really too bad. I thought it was going to be worse than it is. So I'm going to go ahead and tighten this down in position while he pushes on that to keep it where it's supposed to be. Untighten the middle one because that'll hold everything pretty much where it needs to be at. Are you checking that top edge?
Yep.
Okay.
It's in line the whole way.
Cool. Well, I'll do the bottom one now, and that's basically in. But if you're having a problem, if you're trying to do a really nth degree thing, you can take and do that. You can pressure the sections of it where the bolts are at in order to get it to line in really nice and flat. Of course, this fender is about as wavy as a Navy wife, but, you know, it's actually lining better than I thought it would. Not much to talk about here, but that's what you would want to do. You put pressure close to this inside edge with a pry bar, and then you're good to go. There's a bolt that's up in here, and the one thing I will say that's kind of a bummer, our Vintage Air mounting procedure in here is pretty good. I like it okay, but it's causing me a real hassle for trying to get that one bolt to tighten up on the fender. And we're going to go do the same thing on the other side. We're not going to show you that. We'll get the other side lined up, and then we're going to put the bumper on just to see how the bumper fits. Onward and forward. I forgot to use the creeper. All right, so I've put some towels on the end of the bumper to kind of protect it so when we're putting it up, we don't jack the stone guard or the fender. I'm not sure how far down the fender this is going to go. And I'm just going to lift it up into position with Cam. This is always a good idea to have somebody helping you do this stuff. I'll get that one later. Yay. On these Ford bumpers, there is pretty much absolutely no adjustment room on them at all. They sit where they sit. You have a little side to side, but there ain't a whole lot of that.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Yo. Just put it on there so it'll stay there for a second. Can't really get threaded.
Okay. All right.
All right. Well, I'm not going to tighten this thing up yet. We have a few other things to do on the truck. The one thing I will say is I would probably recommend getting some of the wave washers that you can get for the Mustang-style bumpers. Although, I will say that this bumper, there's not a whole lot of playroom. I mean, once you get that thing started, that bumper bolt is done. So that's in there. I'm going to step back and take a look at what we got. I'm going to try to get up now.
Come on, old man.
Shut up. You'll be there one day. Looks terrible. We got
It's almost finished.
It's really not.
No, it's not.
Because even though I did a really good job of getting this grill, because it's very, very straight compared to a lot of them I saw in the price range I could afford.
Yeah.
Because range. These things are gone stupid now that they're not remaking them at this point.
Yeah, did the dies break?
The dies are just worn out. Yeah. And Carpenter has even admitted that when you make those things, they're not real happy. So as scuffy as this thing is, it looks pretty trashy. Again, this part is available, but they just aren't reproducing them again yet. They're supposed to get these back in production again.
Yeah.
So what I'm gonna do while we're here.
Yep. Just sand it down.
Sand it down. And I'm gonna do a video on taking the anodizing off, sanding it down using the different stages of sandpaper, and go in, refinish the grill and the chrome strip that goes here. We'll replace the lettering when we do all that because it's going to look trashier even so. Because the bumper and the nicely repainted stone guard make this stuff look super trashy.
Yeah.
With the old trashy bumper that was on here before, and buddy how that thing was trashed.
It looked perfect.
It looked fine.
Yeah.
But not anymore. This is, yeah, it just needs.
It's good at about telephone pole distance.
Might even be a football field, but I'd go football field.
Yeah,
if it were me.
Safe.
Safe at football field. Well, I mean, anyway, we've given them some ideas on how to do things. Mm-hmm. There's a couple of other things that we could probably go over, but it's all fit and fiddle. It's just really fit and fiddle, and even you're not, you know, you get worn out with it pretty quick. And I'm one of those kind of guys, I just keep going until I get the
way. I get bored.
Yeah, I get the way I want it, and you just get it done.
I just want to drive.
And I want it right. So between the two of us, make a pretty good team. Because you pushed me to get it driven, and I just like, no, we got to do this one more thing. Well, folks, that's our show for this week. Be sure to come back and watch us next time on Auto Resto Mod. You guys have a great week. We'll see you later.
You can drive it in.
I'd rather drive it out and take it around the block.